I start with the video treatment of Premanand and what he has to say in his own voice.
Into family. I thought I should also have such power. And I went around India to find out a guru who could give me such power. And to return back, and I found that there were all tricks. Now, 65, 750 years campaigning against food and drugs. Here's some power stock here, 1500 period miracle. And publishes these albums and journals in his sketch. And his campaign is gathering momentum. He now runs training courses for young guru masters. This man is learning how to levitate. When he says he landed, Premanand reveals the supernatural secret.
This is the hidden thing. This is the place. Get up with the stick and people think it is the beast. And it just lift up the head like this. And people think it has levitated. And then he comes down and then he goes to sleep.
So this sequence featuring Premanand is what I wanted you to see before I start speaking about it. Premanand, I say, is my ideological father. And I am very happy that I am continuing the work that he has started. And the Federation of Indian Wrestling Association is the organization which he founded in Palakkad in Kerala. Anyway, Premanand has a lot of connections with Kerala, particularly with Calicut. He was born here in Tikodi, I think about 20 kilometers from Calicut, where his family had a big business. He was born in 1929. It was the 17th of February. And when he was born, his father, like all good governors of the Brahmin parents, went to the astrologer to make his horoscope. The astrologer said, I will not make a horoscope because this baby will die in a few months. He went to another astrologer, another one. But everybody refused to make Premanand horoscope, saying that this baby is going to die in a few months. No point in making a horoscope. And Premanand died a few months later in 2009. 5th of October, that was a few months. And he used to say, the very fact that I am alive today shows that astrology is nonsense, astrology is rubbish. All astrologers predicted that I die in few months, but I have lived for 8 years. Again, his karma movie was Calicut. Because he was thrown out of the school when he was in third form or so for putting Gandhiji's photograph, or not photograph, but his picture, that time photograph is very, very expensive, in the classroom. In one classroom he put it, the headmaster said, oh, very nice, this should be in every classroom. she set up the Calicut. But Premanand wanted to make it come true, so he went around the shops in Calicut, bought pictures and put them in every class. And for that reason, he and his brother Diamond were thrown out of the school, and probably that's what had happened, because in school you don't get education. So probably that is why he is such an educated man, because he got thrown out of school at a young enough age. And he did not have all the mental thoughts that our teacher put into his mind. He was not a rational young age. He started thinking rationally. After going around India, he wanted to go and see all the holy men and sadhus and everybody. And his father gave him 5 rupees. And he went around the country. He went to Himalaya, where he found the ashram, a brahmachari sadhu, having sex with his devotee. So then he came back. Then he was running his father's business. Then they came into contact with this sadhu of Uttapalli, Satyanarayana. His father was very much impressed. He went to see a dog show in Uti, and Premanand said, his father came back and said, "I went to see dog, but I saw dog." And who was this dog? Sri Bhagwan Satya Sai Baba, who just lived there. Bhagwan, he gave a lot of land to them. That land is given there today. They are running a school there, and then started to work. So, that was another one of the reasons why Premanand started investigating the miracles of Satyanarayana Raj and started demonstrating them. In 1938, he met Abraham Kovur. Abraham Kovur, you know, the person who started the concept of divine miracle exposure program. He used to give a lecture about rational thinking, which would be followed by demonstration of the miracle by one magician called Swami Narendra. The talk would be for about 1.5 hours, the demonstration would be for 1/2 hour. Swami Narendra would do all the government tricks, but he would not explain them. He would just say, the holy champions say they are miracles, I say they are not miracles, I also can do them and I will do it. Then, after the death of Abraham Kovur, there was a big vacuum in the moment. Indian Rationalist Association was basically on the theoretical side, having debates and running a magazine and things like that. Then Premanand started the medical exposure campaign in Kerala. He used to go to villages, driving a jeep, stand on the bonnet of the jeep, and he had a siren. When the door was opened, the siren would give a blast, and all people would come running. He would stand on the bonnet of the jeep, demonstrate a few miracles, burning his hands in a flame, taking, doing RMDs in campus, giving people to the internet. And that is how it became known as miracles. And initially in those days, there was a very, very bad public institution. And as I told me, he said, could you speak for 1/2 hour? And the first time I met him was in 1980. when a magician from outside Mangalore told me that he met two brothers in Coimbatore and they give vibhuti, they do so many things, everything, everything. So, we were naturally interested in bringing them to Mangalore. We had a program in Udupi. That was the first program and the second one was supposed to be in Mangalore. Premanand went on the stage in Udupi and started talking about Om being the sound of creation and how the same sound comes during sexual intercourse. And the moment he said that, there were people with big juttu, namas, sacred tray, rushing on the stage and they told him, sir, you don't want to. You have not paid money to listen to nonsense from you. Because the magician has cleverly said, taught by Premanand and magic by Junior Shankar. And the Junior Shankar was very careful. Actually it was Shankar doing it, but the name was put as Junior Shankar. Because Shankar was employed by the Syndicate Bank and he was prohibited from giving show. So it was Shankar doing the name of Junior Shankar. They stopped Premanand from singing and then they said, you want to see magic? And then the magic was on. Premanand was not allowed to do anything then. After 2 days the program was to be in Mangalore. And in Mangalore, Mr. Premanand will get an opportunity to speak. And he got it. And after that, one campaign started in the newspapers in Mangalore, saying that the Rasmus are saying there is no miracle today. Tomorrow there is no God. So I came and said, why tomorrow? Today it will be a miracle for God. So, again, the Orthodox people got angry. And the magician gave a public statement saying that you have nothing to do with the Rasmus. You are only magician. Then Premanand told me, henceforward, don't arrange any program in people like this. You want to arrange program? You will do. And as Premanand came to be known, NCFCC was headed by Dr. Narendra Nayak. They came to know about him. They invited him to Delhi. And then the National Campaign on Directing Exposure got a definite form. Before that, he used to conduct training programs here and there. So not only he started doing miracles, he started training others to do that. And I am happy to say, I am his first student. Not that he gave me a training program, but his training program was right on the stage. I was translating and he was doing it. And then he told me, anyway you are going to, you know what I am going to tell. You tell what I have to tell in Kannada, then tell me in English what I should do, I will do it. So he will give a commentary in Kannada and then tell him, now he will do it. So he will do it. He said, now talk about the next. And he will speak about the next and then now you have to. So like that he used to. And after a few programs like that he told me, you want to say what I am saying. Now learn to do what I am doing. That's how I started doing this. And then as I said, there was no mission party. Premanand became famous. He took our miracle people, I can't write that the miracle men do not do injustice to the miracle women. Our miracle persons, miracles, were taken all over the world by him. I think he has given programs in maybe 25-30 countries. He has been taught by many, many TV channels all over the world. And Premanand was a man who believed that the primary thing is for the woman to go on. So, whenever he was invited to give a training program, he would say, all Narendra Nayak. They say, why Narendra Nayak, you want to? He says, no, he is better than me. I said, why are you saying that? He says, no, who are? I said, no, I don't believe it. So So once I went to Madhya Pradesh for a training program, I didn't know he was coming. When I went there, I saw Premanand there. I said, why have you come? He said, if I think you are coming, I won't come. He said, I knew that. That is why I told you not to tell you. But why have I come from? He said, I'm not going to give a training program. I'll come to watch your training program. I said, okay, what? And in fact, he laughed and then he came and told me, I'm now confident that we can continue the training program. So, and we were going in parallel for many, many years. And when Discovery Channel wanted to shoot, he said, you shoot him, not me. The famous one on Discovery Channel, difficulty. I did most of the things because he said, he should do. Because he believed that the moment should come up, the others should do it. Somebody told him, you have given us everything to him. You have given over things to him. Yes, he gave him one pot. That Water of India pot you see in Discovery Channel was given by him too. Otherwise, he said, I didn't give him anything. He took everything from me. So that was the greatness of the man. His another ambition was to start a method of science museum. It is started. And it was to be opened now in February 2009. And when I asked him today, he said, why do you want to date? I said, because I want to be there when you open the museum. He said, I won't give you the date. I said, okay, I will cancel program for 1 month and sit. Kaka might sit in Bodham if you don't give me the date. He said, no, I give you the date. Give me the date. And on the previous day of the opening of the Method of Science Museum, his brother Daniel expired. So those who did not give Premanand were asking whether the Museum of Science will be opened on that day or not. Those who did not know it properly said that. But those who knew him very well said, Premanand is going to open the Museum of Science on that day. And he did. Though his brother had died 2 days before, the museum, the Method of Science Museum was opened on time. It was on the first floor. He wanted to build a second floor where he wanted to put working exhibits and a small hall where people could be trained. But that ambition could not be realized. He passed away before he could do that. He had one more ambition. That is to see that the thought of Uttapati is put behind bars. But of course, that ambition could not be realized. He wanted his work to continue after him, and we are all doing that work. We are continuing his work. And that is the best tribute that we can pay to this great man, his prema. He sacrificed his whole life for the cause. His family life was non-existent. He did not have an income. All the income he used to get was from selling his books. But all his life, struggled and worked for the cause of Rashtra. It was not that Premanand was a godlike figure, but no more. Premanand has fought. We all know him very well, are very close to him. But one thing I have to say, that the greatness of this man and all the great things that he has done, a huge seed in which a few grains of the salt are nowhere to eat. They are just washed off the sea of work that he has done, the effort that he has taken, And today, if there are hundreds of activists in India for exposing this miracle, investigating this miracle, it's all because of this movement in which we started. It is for us to continue this movement, and that will be the best to do step by step. He told me, well, I can say happy man now that you are going to continue the work. What about me? What do I do? He said, there is never a headache. My headache is gone. So now it is my headache, or rather our headache, to look for a stable successor to Premanand and his legacy of work. And I think all of us will join together and do it and not. So I thank the science very much for having given me this opportunity to share a few things that I thought about Premanand. We can go and talk days together about Premanand because our association was so close. And the places where we have gone, the times we have been attacked, times we have stranded, etc., etc., too many. Anyway, we are not all, but most of us are twice born, I think. Just like a Brahmin is twice born, most of us at least here are twice born, I think. Because when we are born, we are ready. They trust the God of our heaven, and then you can feel that God is taking time. So I'm on the twice born at least. Premanand was one of the greatest ones. And I think among them we have some born at least who have not been taken that way at all. I think people like Sajit are here. He's not a twice born at least. Because he was never at least. I think there will be others also who are always being at least and will continue to be. So I thank you very much for having given me this opportunity to say a few words about Premanand. I thank the science club of which Premanand and I were the children that have started it. And I am very, very happy that they are doing a very good job. And this is the second Premanand Memorial Lecture there. Organizing, and I do hope that they will continue this tradition. Are you going to continue this tradition of Premanand Memorial Lecture next year also? Yes, okay. So, I think they have started this tradition, and it is for them to continue. And that is the best tribute we can pay to Premanand, who even on his deathbed. Even when he was dying, he made a declaration saying that I am dying, and even when I am dying, I am not believing in any God or any supernatural power. He said, no religious rites will be performed on my death, and my body will be donated to the medical college. And that is what we did. So, thank you very much. Good luck. Continue.